Hey guys, hope you're having an amazing day and welcome to another video. And today I can finally show you how I improved the microphone quality on the Android head unit that I'm using. So let's get into it, shall we? Guys, if there's one common issue most people have gripes with is the microphone quality on Android head units. Now I really haven't noticed it much at all. Probably because I don't use the microphone that often. And when I do, it's usually short and sweet. I've heard many people have said their calls have sounded low, muffled, and almost underwater-like. And it's not isolated to a specific brand, but generally the ones that share the same hardware design, which is pretty much the majority of the Android market. It's a shame that these Android head units aren't designed to use the car's factory microphone. However, I'm sure there's a good technical reason why. Instead, these units have their own separate mics, an onboard one, and an optional external mic jack on the back. So I've tested both inputs, and there seems to be a mysterious conflict between the two. I'm not sure by design, but there's an inherent interference as they carry the same sound distortion. My unit has no software control for either microphone, so I really wanted to get to the bottom of this. First, we need to get the back trim off the unit. We can unscrew all the fasteners on each side. The area that we need to focus on is on the back side of the controls. There's a small cover plate that can be removed. We'll need to push down and out to release it. As you can see here, there's a small circuit board connected by a ribbon. This circuit corresponds with the touch buttons on the front, including the onboard microphone that's found on the very top of my unit. We can gently lift out this circuit and leave the ribbon connected as it is. There seems to be a lot of slack to it, making things easier to maneuver. We do need to flip it over to locate the microphone, which is this really tiny circle thing here. It's connected on the board by two pins. We'll have to desolder those points to remove the microphone off the circuit board. I thought it'd be a good idea to take a marker and mark the top position, just in case we need to put it back or find out which points are positive and negative on the board. There really isn't any marking on the circuit as to which is which. And now it's time to heat up the old soldering iron. Again, the microphone component is really small. I decided to use a stand with an alligator clip to hold it in place while I heat up the underside points. All that's needed then is to pull the board clean away. Now there's a plus symbol on the back of the microphone which indicates the positive lead. I made a good move marking the top of the component because now I can reference those pins to the points on the circuit. The top point seems to be ground and the bottom point looks to be the positive. Now we could extend this microphone component outside the case if that solves the primary issue. But given this opportunity, I wanted to use another external microphone in its place. So my plan now is to solder a new microphone jack adapter to those points. I'm adding flux to help the new solder flow much easier. The red wire is typically positive, which will be soldered to the bottom point as we discovered earlier. Again, your board and components may be different from the one shown here. And I should also point out, I'm also not a professional engineer, so please proceed at your own risk when doing these modifications. You'll most likely lose your warranty at this point doing so. Now I should have had my multimeter handy, because I was worried that I'd accidentally bridge those points, since they were really, really tiny. Should I mess with perfection?
Jonathan, just walk away.
Yeah, Jonathan. Walk away.
So just to explain this Picasso piece, my soldering iron got way too hot since it has no temperature control. And I didn't properly tin my wires either. However, as ugly as it looks, it does check out fine. Knowing that these wires will be pushed and pulled on, I used my glue gun to fix it in place. Now we need to place the cover plate back on, but having the adapter sticking out like this doesn't really work. So I took a tiny saw and filed down the plastic. Now that the modification is finally done, we're ready to test it. I'll be reinstalling this external microphone on my Corolla. This is basically how I'm going to hook it up. We'll have to be careful when placing the back trim on, as we don't want to put too much pressure on the wire. Tell me a joke.
What do you call a shoe made out of a banana? A slipper.
Oh my god. Tell me another one.
What do you get when you put a vest on an alligator? An investigator.
Tell me a better joke.
Why can't a bicycle stand on its own? It's too tired.
So guys, this was a complete success. The external microphone now works in place of the onboard one. Now I should have also tested the secondary microphone input on my unit to see how it sounded now that I've isolated both channels. But I was just satisfied at this point. Again, I'm not at all a heavy user of the microphone. Now I did make a quick test call with someone and was told that the quality is much improved. Not perfect, but better than before. So I'll take that. It now has a cleaner quality, which doesn't have that muffled effect. Now if we bought an even better microphone, I'm sure we can achieve a level comparable to stock. So my friends, I hope this experiment helps those struggling with this particular issue. Comment below if it did. If you liked this video, remember to hit that like button. And if you enjoy my content, please consider subscribing to this humble YouTube channel, as it helps me create more content like this for you guys. Alright, cheers.